Hello, my name is Chris, and this is Writing Delight. The year 2022 is now over. The year 2023 is here. And I would like to take a look back at the past year and show you my top 10 fountain pens. And not necessarily the latest fountain pens, but the fountain pens that I have used the most in the past year. The ones I enjoyed the most. So, very subjective. Next year, I'll do a new top 10. Let's see what has changed by then. In 10th place, the Diplomat Magnum. An inexpensive and beautiful fountain pen, shown here in the John Doe variant, which changes color depending on how the light hits it. I have it with a fine nib. It has the Jarhaberm Poisson de Lune filled in. What is probably unusual about my copy is that the nib has some flex to it, very pleasant and gives a living writing pattern. But supposedly, not every Magnum can do that. In 9th place, the Cross Townsend. A simple looking fountain pen, but I like to use it for signatures. This is also due to the broad nib. It is filled with the ink Jarhaberm Bleu de Profondeur. Oh yes, this is an 18K gold nib. And this one also has a clear line variance. On place 8, the Diplomat Aero. And this is the first version in orange with black trim elements. Still a great A catcher. This one writes pleasantly with its medium nib. By the way, it is filled with Kaweco Sunrise Orange. As usual with Diplomat, this steel nib is rather stiff. On place 7, the Online Bohemian Art. A fountain pen in midi size, or fun size. I simply enjoy this fountain pen with this good writing medium nib. Here it is filled with Calamus Antique Green. And the nib also shows flex behavior. In 6th place, the Otterhood Design 04. A noble pen with a relaxing and iridescent pattern. The medium steel nib used here writes pleasantly soft with the Pannonia Mustvirus ink filled in. And a little line variance is also achievable. In 5th place, the Cleo Skribent Aura Laguna Dragon. A fountain pen with a striking pattern and a long name. The pattern is unique to each fountain pen. Incidentally, a 14-karat gold nib is used here to write the current dash vibrant green ink. The nib can achieve a slight line variance, but others can do more. In fourth place, the Waldmann Commander. A heavy fountain pen, but with that name? A wonderfully smooth writing broad nib. Not only with the Gerber Rouge Grenade used here. And the fountain pen can also vary the stroke thickness a bit. Let's move on to the top 3. These are, at place 3, the Omas Emotica. An older fountain pen with some special features. Because here you can fold down the clip on the cap and has so immediately a stand for short interruptions when writing. But not only that, the nib also has a very special writing behavior, because a titanium nib is used here. And the ink diamond writer's blood is filled in. Flexing with this fountain pen is possible without force, and can do more than I can show here on the smooth paper. In second place, the Diplomat Nexus. Just shown in 2022 and already on place 2. But this eyedropper with its medium nib is just fun. Even if the nib is stiff, I like the weight, the size, and the fact that this is a modern eyedropper. But you have already seen more about it in the video linked above. And on place 1, the Visconti Homo Sapiens. Many people know this fountain pen. A very special fountain pen, but with the current secondary nib does not do well on smooth paper. I will change the nib again soon. It was damaged and soon it will be repaired back to me. Both are stub nibs made of 23K palladium, by the way. The Dream Touch nibs. Filled in is the Diatomantis Black Red. And the fact that this fountain pen can do a little line variance is basically lost in the thick ink application. You see, a colorful mix of fountain pens. But these are the fountain pens that moved me the most in 2022. The ones I love to write with the most. The ones I use the most. Some new fountain pens, like the Diplomat Nexus. Some older fountain pens, like the Omas Emotica. And also evergreens, not just mine, like the Visconti Homo Sapiens. Which fountain pen has been your top fountain pen in 2022? Thank you so much for watching. And also in 2023, I have again some hopefully interesting videos planned for you. See you next time.